Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. In this lecture, we are going to use this microchip MCP9808 temperature sensor to display the temperature on this LCD1602 display with I2C, which has only four wires. We have learned how to use this MCP9808 temperature sensor to display the temperature on the serial monitor, and we have explained the hardware, and also we have seen how to use this LCD1602. For that reason, we are not going to explain the functionality and feature of this or this one. We just go directly to the code, wiring, and demonstration. Here is a wiring diagram for MCP9808 temperature sensor with the LCD1602 I2C module. Because this needs 5 volts and this also needs 5 volts, 3.3 volts. I'm using the breadboard to supply power for both of these. I've brought a red wire to this point where there is a red line, and I brought a green wire from the ground to this point, which has a blue line on the breadboard. And then for the SDA and SCL, from this is SDA using a black wire, I've brought it to a point. And then also I brought another wire from A5, that's clock or SCL, to a point beside it. So VCC of the module have been connected to 5 volts, ground of this temperature sensor have been connected to the ground, and SCL have been connected using red wire to the left side. This is SCL, which goes to A5, and SDA have been connected to the right side, which goes to A4. Same thing for the display module. Ground have been connected to the ground, VCC have been connected to the VCC, SDA have been connected to the right using the gray wire, and SCL have been connected to the left using this purple wire. Here is the wiring on actual module. From ground, I brought this green wire to this side, which has this blue line, and from 5 volts, I have brought this red wire to the line that has a red line beside it. A4 have been connected to the left side, that's a clock, and A5 have been connected on this side. For the temperature module, the left side, this yellow wire have been connected from VCC to this 5 volts here, and the second line, the orange, have been connected from pin ground, have been connected on this side, which is all ground. And then I have the red wire, the SCL, have been connected on this side, and SDA have been connected using brown to the right of it. Here's the wiring for the LCD. From the left, this is ground, using black wire, have been connected on this side to the ground. The white is a VCC, have been connected to the left side, and this is SDA, the gray wire have been connected to the right, and SCL is the last pin, the pink, which have been connected to the left. Let me now explain the code. This portion is exactly the same as a device without a display, and this portion is for the LCD. I've explained it before, but again, this is part of the library, this line. You don't need to include anything. This is the header file from the library for liquid crystal display for the LCD. You have to download and include it. And we are creating from this class, we create an instance of it as an object, and we pass the address. You have to run the I2C scanner that I will provide you to make sure that you get the right address, and this 16 is number of characters, 2 is number of lines. This is done for the LCD screen. Inside the setup, I've removed all the serial monitor data we put lcd.begin, the one that we create, we use .begin to initialize the LCD, then turn the backlight on, clear the previous values, and then set cursor to 00. And then what we do is we check this one that before was used with serial monitor. This time we print error on the LCD in case if there is an issue with the module. Otherwise, we print MCP9808 test, and then we wait for 2 seconds so the user can read this information. Once the setup is done, then this portion clears the screen because this is loop and we continuously run this code. We set the cursor at 00 and we print this text on the first character of first line. From here it starts, so this occupies the first line. This portion of the code is responsible for printing only this portion, the degrees in Celsius. We use the LCD set cursor at character 0 line 1, which is here. That's line 0, that's line 1, character 0, and we get a temperature and print it as Celsius. And then we go set cursor, we print character 2223, which will print this degree symbol for us, and we set it at character 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's at 5, line 1. After that we go to character 6 and print the C. This is a text inside double quotation. This portion is for Fahrenheit, and we start after that was 6, we start with 8, we left the 7, we go to 8, print the temperature using get temp with a single quotation F, this is a one character, and then we start from 14, this is the 14, and we print the degree symbol, and at 15, line 1, we go and print F. Then there is a 1 second delay, and the code runs over and over again, and this place, as you can see, that small blink is every second. And here is the demonstration. The code is running, the LCD also displays the temperature in Celsius with the degree symbol and C, and there is one space, and this is for Fahrenheit. I've left one extra space here because the Fahrenheit will become 3-digit very quickly when the temperature increases, so this can shift to the right. And now let me apply some heat with my heat gun. And as you can see, it jumped up to 80 degrees. This is 152 degrees Fahrenheit, and it perfectly displays the temperature. I just removed this LCD 1602, and now I've connected the 2004 with 20 character and 4 line. I just swapped it, took that out and inserted this one, but we have to set the I2C address for this. This is a I2C scanner. I will provide you the link. You can download it, and let's upload it. Open the serial monitor. As you can see, it found two devices. The first one is 0x18. That is the temperature sensor, which in most cases you will get 0x18. And this is 0x27. That is the new display. And if I remove this, you will see that one of them disappeared. And now let me just connect this one. And as you can see, this is 3F. The other one was 0x27, that was 27. And I have another color. This is blue. And this is 0x26. This is now 27 0x27. And here I have to make this to 7 and upload the code. And as you can see, the code has been uploaded and we have a lot of room. We can shift it, or maybe we can put the Fahrenheit in the next line and next line. I have not changed any setting in terms of number of line and number of characters. For that reason, when you do that, it can work only with this portion. I've just swapped this and selected the I2C address, it works. But if I select in the code this one as 20 and 4, then I can use the other portion, just update the code in terms of character and line. And here, if you face problem with the temperature sensor address, you can pass the address directly here inside the begin. You can type it, you can pass the address exactly like this, and you will run I2C scanner, which I just shown you, and if you found different address, you can pass the address here and it will just work fine. This was how to use this MCP9808 temperature sensor with LCD. Thank you for watching. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates on my upcoming videos.